you're a gamer or just someone who has a really nice spec'd out PC, you would have probably already heard the term graphics card, and most likely you know exactly what it is used for. But how exactly does it work? What causes the graphics card to work how it does? Well, in this video, I'll be talking about just that, and I hope you learn something new, so why don't we jump right into it? Now, before we get into how graphics cards work, let's first set up a base as to what a graphics card is. Your computer's graphics card is the component responsible for producing the visual output from your computer. Virtually all programs produce visual output. The video card is a piece of hardware that takes that output and tells the monitor which of the dots on the screen to light up and in what color to allow you to see it. The CPU, working in conjunction with software applications, sends information about the image to the graphics card. The graphics card decides how to use the pixels on the screen to create the image. It then sends that information to the monitor through a cable, either a classic VGA cable or an HDMI cable, but in most cases with newer cards, people tend to use HDMI connections. To make a 3D image, the graphics card first creates a wireframe out of straight lines, then it rasterizes the image or fills in the remaining pixels. It also adds lighting, texture, and color. For fast-paced frames, the computer has to go through this process about 60 times per second, which correlates with the phrase 60 frames per second. Without a graphics card to perform the necessary calculations, the workload would be too much for the computer to handle. One of the main things that a graphics card needs is memory. The memory holds the color of each pixel. In an extremely simple situation where your display resolution would be 640 by 480 and you would have a black and white screen, each pixel may only be black and white, so you just need 1 bit to store each pixel's color. Since a byte holds 8 bits, then 640 divided by 8 or 80 bytes to store the pixel colors for one line of pixels on the display. Now we're getting into a little bit of binary and a little bit of storage stuff, so you should probably know a little bit of the basis of how stuff storage and things like this work within the computer. You need 480 by 80 or 38,400 bytes of memory to hold all of the pixels visible on your display. The second thing a graphics card needs is a way for the computer to change the graphics card's memory. This is normally done by connecting the graphics card to the card bus on the motherboard. The computer can send signals through the bus to alter the memory. There are situations where your refresh rate is 60 frames per second. This means that the graphics card scans the entire memory array one bit at a time and does this 60 times every second. It sends signals to the monitor for each pixel on each line and then sends a horizontal sync pulse. It does this repeatedly for all 480 lines and then sends a vertical sync pulse. So we just talked about black and white. Now let's talk about color. When a graphics card handles color, it does it in one of two ways. A true color card devotes 3 or 4 bytes per pixel. 4 bytes allows an extra byte for an alpha channel. On a 1600 by 1200 pixel display, this adds up to about 8 million bytes of video memory. The other alternative is to use 1 byte per pixel and then use these bytes to index a color lookup table or CLUT. The CLUT contains 256 entries with 3 or 4 bytes per entry. A modern card contains its own high-power central processing unit or CPU that is optimized for graphics operations. Depending on the graphics card, this CPU will either be a graphics coprocessor or a graphics accelerator. You can think of a coprocessor as a co-worker and an accelerator as an assistant. The coprocessor and the CPU work simultaneously while the accelerator receives instructions from the CPU and then carries them out. In the coprocessor system, the graphics card driver software sends graphics-related tasks directly to the graphics coprocessor. The operating system sends everything else to the CPU. With a graphics accelerator, the driver software sends everything to the computer CPU. The CPU then directs the graphics accelerator to perform specific graphics-intensive tasks. For example, the CPU might say to the accelerator, "Draw a polygon with these 3 vertices," and the accelerator would do the work of painting the pixels of the polygon into the video memory. I could probably go a little bit more in depth, but this is meant to be a somewhat simple and short video to people who are curious as to how a normal computer graphics card would work. I left a bit of information down in the description below so that you can actually read what I just said to you guys, so feel free to check that out. And thanks for watching. If you like the video, learned anything new or want more, feel free to subscribe, comment on the thing down below, and subscribe for new videos every single week. Also, feel free to check our previous tech tips videos where you can learn some cool new stuff by clicking the links provided in the description below, if I actually remember to do that. But once again, thanks for watching guys, and I will be seeing you in the next video.